Hi everyone, myself Kala Devi, working as assistant professor in the department of computer science and engineering. So let us see the concept of class and objects in C++. So in this class we are going to understand the concept of class and objects, syntax, and how to identify the class and objects for any given problem and its implementation. So at the end of a class, anyone can be able to write a simple program in C++ using class and objects. First, we will see the concept of object. So, objects is nothing but it can be anything in the real world. Any object can be identified individually. Each object has its own characteristics. The object can be a person, bank account, or it can be anything. So around us in the classroom, we can have many objects. We can identify many objects. Objects can be a chair, light, fan, or a desk. Our students, every student in the class, for an example of objects. So here, each object has its own characteristics. Characteristics of an object can be described in terms of properties and behaviors. Properties and behaviors. Properties and behaviors of each object has unique value. So for any object oriented programming language, it's the very first thing important, we have identifying object. So next we are going to see about classes. Class, it is similar kind of objects can be grouped under a class. So objects, the collection of objects with same properties can be defined under a class. The class which describe the objects. So class contain the properties and function of objects. So to write any program using C++, first we have to identify class and objects. The object for the given simple problem statement. The problem statement is getting length, breadth and height of box from the user and display its volume. For this given problem, first we have to identify the class. Okay, the class here it can be a box. Then we have to identify attributes and behavior. The attributes can be a length, breadth and height. The behavior can be a set data, or this is a few data about box, few behavior of box, set data and get volume. So before writing any program, it is very helpful to design a class diagram. Then we can easily translate into your programs. So these are the simple examples for class diagram for few objects. Car can have a model, year of manufacture, color, speed. These are the attributes. And behavior of car can be a start, move and stop. For another object, mobile. A mobile can IMEI code. It's whether it is a single SIM or a processor, SIM card. And behavior can be a root, whether it can connect to Bluetooth, dial, receive, send message. So next thing, we have to know the syntax of class. Class, start with the class, keyword class, then followed by class name. Within the curly braces, we have to define the access specifier, data members, and member function. Finally, it should end with curly brace and semicolon. The access specifier, which specify the boundary where we can access the data, boundary area where we can access data members of a class. So this is example for simple class definition. The class box, so which contain three attributes, length, breadth and height. Then two behaviors, that is function, set data and volume. Then next here, the member function here, length, breadth and height are the data members of a class box. Set data and volume are the member behaviors or function of a class box. So the member function, it should be grouped under members, data members should be grouped under the access specifier, private and public. The private data cannot be accessed outside the class. Public data can be accessed outside the class using object. Next thing, you have to define the member function. The member function can be defined either inside a class or outside the class. So inside the class can be defined, so it should be defined within the curly brace, or it can be defined outside the class by using scope resolution operator. Outside the class using scope resolution operators. So after defining a member function, next thing is to create an object. Object, at the time of creating an object, the memory is allocated for the data of an object, where we can store the data of objects. So here box is a class, it is a data type. Class is a data type. So for that we can create a variable. Here the box, it is just this objects. Box from here is an object. So we can access data members of a class by using object and member as a dot member access operator, and then data member box 1.name. Similarly, we can access member function of a class by using object name. So member access operator dot and then member function name, then the arguments. So this is a simple program to get length, breadth and height of a class and calculate its volume. So here this box, it contains three data members and two member functions. The two member functions are defined outside the class. Outside the class, then after defining it, we can create an object from the main function. So by using main function object box, here objects are box 1 and box 2. By using this object, we can invoke the member function set data. By invoking the function member function set data, we have to assign the arguments. Then we can call the member function volume to display the volume of a box. Similarly, we can set the data for the object box to display its volume. Thank you.